In this problem, we're thinking about the formal position, velocity, and acceleration vectors for an object in uniform circular motion. And I'll post a link to the video where this was derived. But the position as a function of time for an object moving in a circular path of radius r is given by an r cosine omega t times I hat plus r sine omega t times j hat, where omega is the angular velocity. And we've also assumed that this object starts along the positive x-axis. In other words, the initial angle was zero. To get the velocity vector, we take a time derivative. And the first term produces a minus sign because I'm differentiating the cosine. And the chain rule produces a factor of omega. So I end up with a negative r omega sine omega t I hat plus r omega cosine omega t j hat. Then my acceleration vector for any moment in time is found by taking another time derivative, and the chain rule produces another factor of omega, and I end up with a negative r omega cosine omega t I hat minus, because I'm differentiating a cosine in the second term, r omega squared sine omega t j hat. And then the particular question I'm asked in this problem is to show that the acceleration is always perpendicular to the velocity vector. So we're going to take a dot product between the velocity and acceleration vectors. That means we pairwise multiply the coefficients of these unit vectors. And for the first one, I get a positive result because there's two negatives there. And I get an r squared omega cubed sine omega t cosine omega t. And in my second term, I get a negative result because one of them is positive and one's negative. And I get an r squared omega cubed cosine omega t sine omega t. And then I realize everything in these two terms is the same, except one of them is positive and one's negative, so those add to zero. And anytime the dot product vanishes, you know you're looking at two vectors that are perpendicular, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.